A redknapp made his first return to Upton Park since leaving the Hammers. Could they record back-to-back wins?
The man on the wall, it's his goal trap. It's in, it's a second. Pedro Mendes, oh, he's done it again. They're 3-0 up. Great work by the man. Open it up for Portsmouth, and they have a fourth. Harry Redknapp returns to his old stamping ground, comes away with all 3 points, a 4-2 win, and the hope of survival continues.
Portsmouth saw themselves draw level with Birmingham as the end-of-season scramble began. Fulham's win against Chelsea all but guaranteed their safety.
A Mark Viduka special one, goal of the month. Wayne Rooney was the top player, turning up the heat on Chelsea, and another Manager of the Month award for Sir Alex's collection.
April saw the last ever North London derby between Arsenal and Spurs at Highbury, with a Champions League spot almost certainly awaiting the winners. It didn't disappoint, but proved inconclusive.
Gary, I just feel that if Arsenal don't win today, they're really going to have to win the Champions League if they're to play in it next season. Tainio, and Davies is onside. Arsenal are playing down, and Robbie Keane has scored! Whilst Arsenal were reduced to 10 men, and Jens Lehmann has come out and is remonstrating with Edgar Davies.
And now the two managers are as well.
Well, this game has exploded. Bayor's done well against Del Terry. Henry, chance, goal! Thierry Henry! There is still hope for Arsenal! It is advantage Tottenham in the race for fourth place, and with it Champions League football.
Newcastle's revival continued under Glenn Rhoda, but at the back of every Geordie fan's mind was how could they replace the irreplaceable? Alan Shearer's record is hugely impressive. Nearly 800 games for club and country with 409 goals, 205 of those for his beloved Newcastle. It was a special moment when he took to the field for his final North East derby.
Alan Shearer says as he gets older, the feeling of scoring gets sweeter and sweeter, and that will taste very nice indeed.
A bittersweet day for the former England captain. Torn knee ligaments meant his illustrious career ended three games early. But at the next home game, the St James's Park crowd showed their appreciation.
Out of the blue, April saw the possibility of a title race after all. Manchester United arrived at the Reebok looking to extend a run of seven straight league wins and close the gap on Chelsea, who they knew had already dropped points at Birmingham in an earlier kick-off. That was all the encouragement they needed. Louis Sahar scored his 14th goal of the season, and Ruud van Nistelrooy came off the bench to grab United's winner, his 150th goal for the club, and their eighth consecutive league victory. Perhaps the English Premier League title wasn't out of reach after all. In early March, Chelsea had been 18 points clear of United, 1 month on, and the deficit had been cut to seven.
We're not far away from them. I think the consistency and the experience they have, they defend very well. But we're not far away from them. In terms of quality, I don't think we're behind them at all.
But Ferguson's men had a huge hurdle to overcome before the race could be officially declared on. The visit of Arsenal to Old Trafford, where memories of last year's classic match still lingered.
Here is Wayne Rooney. It's still Rooney, and it's Park.
That put pressure on Chelsea, who were at home to West Ham. A goal down, and then a player down when Manish saw red. They found themselves in trouble.
Didier Drogba, blocked by Hislop, second time, it's 1-1. And Crespo! Terry! scored four times.
Now they require just three wins to retain their title. Fergie could only hope for another slip-up as United entertained Sunderland on Good Friday. Anything other than a win and the Black Cats were down.
And it has finished here, astonishingly, 0-0. Sunderland are officially relegated and have helped Chelsea enormously.
The race was over. Chelsea then had the chance to clinch the title at home to United.
What a start for Chelsea! They're ahead inside the first 5 minutes. They're half an hour away from becoming champions, and that surely means the championship trophy is staying at Stamford Bridge. There goes Cole again. He's fed that one cleverly through. There could be a third! Ricardo Carvalho has just put the icing on Chelsea's cake. It's 3-0.
Then, the moment the whole country feared with the World Cup fast approaching.
Feeling. We know one day we have to lose a championship, but now we deserve to win the title. 12 points is a big difference. We are top of the league since the first day, and I think it's a great achievement for us.
So there is the confirmation, the title sewn up with two games to go. Chelsea, the only club other than Manchester United to retain the Premier League crown.
Portsmouth were the side on song, picking up 17 points from an available 24. That was UEFA Cup form. With just two games to go, Portsmouth travelled to Wigan, followed by 5,000 fans. Victory and a bad result for Birmingham would send the two Midland clubs down. Portsmouth made the worst possible start.
Taylor! Oh, it's off the post! He's done it! Ben Johnny has got his first goal for the club! Taylor scores it! It could on this very day ensure Portsmouth survive!
That comeback meant unless Birmingham scored, both they and West Brom would be relegated. Steve Bruce desperately needed a winner.
Fossil! Gibbon stops it! And again! And Shea Gibbon may well have condemned Birmingham to relegation. It is all over. Portsmouth are staying in the Premiership. Harry Houdini has done it. He's pulled off a great escape act.
It did look almost impossible. I'd be alive, I said, otherwise. I felt both West Brom and Birmingham were decent sides with good young managers, and it did look very, very difficult. But we put an unbelievable run together. To take 20 points from nine games has been magnificent.
So Portsmouth had completed an incredible recovery. They were safe with one game to go, a monumental feat for Harry Redknapp in a turbulent year for the charismatic manager.
Gary Cahill's spectacular first goal for Aston Villa captured the imagination. With the World Cup approaching, Steven Gerrard's form was promising. And of course, Harry Houdini won the Manager's Award.
A poignant moment of the month for Charlton Athletic and the Premier League. After 15 years at the helm, Alan Kirbishley announced his summer departure from the Addicks. He leaves the club in a much healthier state than he found it in.
With the championship and relegation sorted, the big question in May was who would claim fourth spot. If Spurs won at West Ham, it would be theirs. Intrigue beforehand, the game came close to being called off after 10 Spurs players went down with food poisoning.
It's Jermaine Defoe! He scored! Jermaine Defoe scores back at his old club! Real Coca Ben Ayoun! Yossi Ben Ayoun, they well finished off Tottenham Hotspur's European Champions League dream!
A few miles away, Arsenal came out at Highbury for the last time before their summer move to the Emirates Stadium. Wigan were hoping to spoil the party.
Oh, I say! What embarrassment for Jens Lehmann!
But the Gunners' maestro came to their rescue yet again.
Thierry Henry! Oh, bad ball! It's a gift! Henry around Pollitt, an empty net! North back end, Arsenal lead! Thierry Henry, hat-trick!
The perfect way to wave goodbye to their home of 93 years. A Champions League fourth spot finish and the golden boot for Henry, who scored 27 times.
Celebrations too for Sven-Göran Eriksson's successor as he waved goodbye to the Premier League. It capped a great year for Steve McClaren, who can count taking Borough to the UEFA Cup final as an outstanding achievement.
Not a good year for Ruud van Nistelrooy, who looks to be on his way out of Old Trafford after falling out with the manager.
Good news for Glenn Rhoda, as he was given the green light to become Newcastle manager on a permanent basis.
A final look at the table, and Chelsea will be going for a hat-trick next season. Tottenham, Blackburn and West Ham made it into the UEFA Cup. Birmingham, West Brom and Sunderland are down to be replaced by Reading, Sheffield United and either Leeds or Watford.
We sign off the 2005-2006 English Premier League season with a tribute to the champions Chelsea. For the first time in their history, the Blues have taken the title in successive seasons. The question is, will any team be able to catch them next season? From Marcus Buckland and me, Dave Beckett, see you in August.